Miiri Kotche is Clinical Associate Professor at the Richard and Lone Hill Department of Bioengineering. Her focus is on undergraduate education and medical product development. She leads the Freshman Engineering Success Program and runs an NIH-funded bioengineering clinical immersion program for undergraduates with an interest in medical product development. Dr. Kotche is also the director of the Mad Lab at the UIC Innovation Center, which provides early concept and business development of medical devices for clinicians across our campus.
I'm a proud alumna of both UIC and UIUC. My father immigrated to the U.S. from Korea to study electrical engineering, where he met my mom, the daughter of a dairy farmer who is studying genetics and is now a nurse. So it probably isn't a stretch to say I inherited their combined interests in engineering and healthcare to become a bioengineer. I was working as an engineer and began teaching college part-time, and teaching really inspired me to advocate for women in STEM, to serve as a mentor, and to bridge cultures. I came to UIC to earn my PhD and became involved with Engineers Without Borders. My experiences in Guatemala and Cambodia, in rural and remote areas where access to basic medical interventions is limited, with no running water or reliable electricity, helped to deepen my understanding of the types of skills needed by future engineers in order to contribute to the global health challenges of our time. As an educator, we are training our students to develop solutions to diagnose, prevent, and treat illnesses using the latest science and technology. Some of my colleagues are pushing the boundaries in areas of bioinformatics, visualization, engineered biomaterials, and biomechanics. But we also share a goal to create an inspired and well-rounded engineer who has the potential to solve issues related to illness and disease using low-cost and simple methods that can have large and far-reaching impact to bring increased access to medical care, such as mobile health technology or rapid diagnostic devices. One example is a project assigned in a sophomore class I teach called Clinical Problems in Bioengineering. The class works in small teams to reach a solution to clinically motivated real-world bioengineering problems. One of the three problems over the semester has a global health aspect to investigate. A few years ago, I based one of these problems on a Gates Foundation challenge to find a solution to measure the amount of blood loss during postpartum hemorrhage, which the World Health Organization estimates contributes to 30% of maternal deaths in Africa and Asia. I invited Dr. Valerie Dobias, UIC emergency medicine physician, to be our guest speaker. One student pursued this project after the class under her guidance, and her team won an award at the Engineering Expo competition. Dr. Dobias and her colleagues have really evolved this project to the next level. And although I am not a part, I am really proud that the kernel of this project came from my class and that interested students and faculty, including another one of tonight's presenters, Dr. Geller, have carried it forward. The student, as advisor for Engineering World Health, a national organization that supports bioengineers to improve healthcare delivery in the developing world, our students continue to develop low-tech innovations. Students have worked on fabricating electrosurgical units and ECG simulators for use in training around the world. Student leaders teach freshmen about electronic components and how to solder, build, and test their boards. These kits are then sent to programs in developing countries to help train technicians to repair the nearly 40% of critical medical equipment that is either broken or in need of replacement. Another project these future engineers are working on involves 3D printing assistive hand devices, where the total cost can be as low as $20. Students can easily design and fabricate the device, test it, and make improvements as necessary, a great exercise in applying the engineering design process. In March, I am taking bioengineering students to Vietnam with the International Pediatric Specialist Alliance for the Children of Vietnam, founded by Dr. Ashwan Holterman, professor of surgery at our Peoria Regional Campus and a member of the UIC Center for Global Health. Our goal is to do a site assessment and evaluate ways we might be able to address needs through low-cost medical technology. We hope to develop an inexpensive laminar flow hood to reduce contamination when mixing medications and handling infectious agents. One final example of a global health project I'm working on is as part of the wonderfully named MAD Lab, the Medical Accelerator for Devices Laboratory at the UIC Innovation Center, sponsored by the College of Medicine and the Office of Technology Management. The interdisciplinary team is comprised of graduate-level students from engineering, industrial design, marketing, and medicine. Our goal is to provide early concept validation for medical device ideas brought to us from throughout the UIC community and be a pipeline to help commercialize great ideas through the Office of Technology Management. We're just closing our first call for entries on Friday and not long ago completed our second pilot project brought to us by Professor Emeritus and neonatologist Dr. Dharmapuri Vidyasagar. We worked on a project with Dr. Vidyasagar to develop a very inexpensive alternative to costly incubators for low resource settings in rural India. Many medical clinics do not have incubators for premature infants, and we learned that hypothermia is a serious risk for these children. It is not uncommon to use plastic grocery bags to wrap a newborn infant to retain body heat. Dr. Vidyasagar challenged us to find an alternative to using these plastic bags, a device that will passively retain heat and be nearly as inexpensive as a plastic bag. Lastly, some of the things that I love about my job as part of the faculty here at UIC are the widespread opportunities to collaborate with colleagues in engineering, medicine, business, and design, and the chance to examine some of these global health problems and bring students into the conversation. While we examine the issues related to these problems and try to find potential solutions, I also hope to ignite the same curiosity I have about the world in which we live with my students, so they carry this with them when they leave the university and move on to find their place in the world. The more empathy and global context our students have about their ability to contribute to society in big ways or small really helps to prepare the next generation for the challenges ahead. My goal is to help create inspired and well-rounded engineers who have the technical skills necessary, but also the globally minded outlook required to have a lasting impact on society. Thank you.